I have four brothers. That's too many. I know more about sports than any person ever needed to know, ever. I can agree with them on some sports. I like football, pro football, mainly just because I like looking at John Madden because I'm reminded of how healthy I am. How has he not yet spontaneously combusted on national television? As long as he's alive, we've all got another 20 years. Because every year his head gets progressively larger, and I'm like, I did not go buy a bigger television. This guy's head is like, it's taken over a whole plasma screen. Like, I just thought your head quit growing at a certain age, but now I'm concerned because I think between him and Ted Kennedy, there is ample proof that your head can turn into a Mardi Gras float on your own body. I love Ted Kennedy, but at this point, his head is so gigantic. He looks more like a bobblehead than an actual bobblehead of Ted Kennedy. I think he's one guy who could actually live without a body, just be a head. Like 10 years from now, we're going to turn on CNN, and it'll be some Senate confirmation hearing. It's just going to be his head on a table going, and another thing, I have another question. They're just patting him on the head. That's it, Ted, settle down. John Madden. My brothers don't like him. They're like, well, he's all he does is overstate the obvious. I'm like, I know, but it's Monday Night Football, and maybe I've had some beers, and maybe that's exactly what I would like to hear. Maybe I need to be reminded that if they don't move the ball forward, they're not going to score any points. I like golf. I shouldn't watch the Masters. I do. I shouldn't watch it, though, because if you don't follow golf, there's a big tournament played in Augusta, Georgia, at a private country club, and they have no women members. They will not allow women members. It's like, it's ridiculous at this point. And every year, there's these women that protest, and you're like, God love you, ladies. But I just do not see it happening. I have seen those old Southern crusty white guys running that place. They don't even like Tiger being out there, okay? You know they're sitting in that clubhouse going, there's a colored boy out on the coast somewhere that is not carrying any clubs. I say. Somebody said he's half Chinese, for Christ's sake. Well, how could you possibly have a colored man and a Chinaman in the same person? This is ridiculous. I'm calling Dwight Eisenhower. Get him on the phone. But I watch it. I like to watch their press conference. Even if you hate golf, you know nothing about it. If you're ever flipping through and you see old Southern guys in all green jackets, do not change the channel because it's the funniest 10 minutes of television. Because they want to be taken seriously, but they don't know that to us, they all sound exactly like Foghorn Leghorn. And they're so slow. And they buy that chunk of TV time so that there's no ads. They can take their time. And they come on, they're just like, hello, and welcome to Augusta National Golf Club. I actually died 187 years ago. But miraculously, I'm still the chairman and CEO of Augusta National Golf Club. And my name is Mr. Hootie Booty Cahootie Johnson. Standing next to me is Vice President Red Rover, send him on over. Even though we're multimillionaires, we giggle at a good nickname. Now let's get back to the coloreds and the women. I like to watch the Olympics, the winter, that's my favorite, because the figure skating, because I wanted to be a figure skater when I was a little kid. That was my big dream. Isn't it sad, too, the older you get in life, you just gotta start scratching crap off your list, because you know it's never, ever gonna happen. Like, well, never, ever gonna be a figure skater. Probably too late to find out I'm some sort of prodigy. Oprah has those little bastards on a lot. Do not watch that if you're in a depressed mood because she's so excited. She's like, ladies and gentlemen, he's 5 and he wrote an opera. Really? Well, I hope he never gets a date. That's ridiculous. But then I think, what if we're all prodigies, but it's just that something we haven't tried yet, right? Like, I've never done pottery. What if I'm a prodigy at pottery, but I've never done... What if I sat down at a pottery meal and made a cup and people were like, holy Christ, lady. That is the most phenomenal cup ever made. I did want to be a figure skater, though. What's sad, too, is, though, even as a kid, I thought, boy, I would do it alone. I would never team up with a guy for the pair thing, because I knew, even at, like, six, I didn't have enough control over my temper. Like, if I made it to the Olympics with some guy, and out of nowhere, he just fell, oh, I would skate around just to chop off his fingers. I would. I would be so mad. I'd be like, there you go. Now when you're nubbing your cereal spoon in the morning, you can look at that box and remember why we're not on it. The Olympics are getting ridiculous anyway. They keep adding sports where you're like, really, is that a sport? Like, golf is not in the Summer Olympics, but they added the trampoline. Yeah. The trampoline. In other words, people flipper. The trampoline, to me, is much more of a backyard activity. If we're going to have that, then I think we should have hide and go seek. We now go live to the hide and go seek arena. Bob, what's going on over there?
Well, the Canadians have been missing for over 8.5 hours. They're very quiet people. And the Polish team is still, unfortunately, standing in the middle of the arena. I don't think they fully understand the hide part.
God love the Canadians. They have a big comedy festival up there once a year. They're very nice people. Canada's a nice place. It's like our attic. You forget it's up there, but then when you get up there, you're like, wow, look at all this crap. I totally forgot this was up here. I learned my lesson, though. Don't use your cell phone if you go to Canada, because it won't say Rome, and it just dials normally. And I was like, oh, great, whatever, right? So I made all these calls. I get home, and I get a bill from AT&T for like $9 million. And not only is AT&T mean, they're condescending. The lady was like, well, ma'am, Canada is another country. I was like, well, not really. I could see Detroit, and their animals looked exactly like ours. It's ridiculous. For this kind of money, I at least want to see like a wombat or something hopping through the lobby where I'm like, wow, there was something taller than me to hop by. I have to hang up now.